best known for his monumental cuts, holes, apertures, and excision to the facades of homes and historic buildings in New York, Garden Matta Clark's work conveys what happened in the Bronx in the late 60s and is now open to the public at the Bronx Museum.
In 1972, Garden Matta Clark, who had recently graduated from architecture at Cornell University upstate, he was living in downtown Manhattan, and he decided to come to the Bronx because he knew that there was a lot of abandoned buildings. So he went into some of these abandoned buildings, and he began to use those abandoned structures as material for his sculptures. In addition to the Bronx floors and the photographs, we have almost all the photographs that he did of graffiti. And as you know, graffiti culture in the Bronx is very, very important. And I think this will be very interesting for the Bronx community to come and acknowledge that.
His very first series of architectural cuttings, for which he's best known, happened in 1972 and 1973 in the South Bronx. And at that point, he was really just trying to bring the crisis that was happening in the South Bronx to the attention of the rest of the city.
Garden Matta Clark, an architect, includes over 100 artworks, rarely seen materials from his archives, and three-dimensional film projections.
He felt as an artist, it was his responsibility to really deal with the everyday, what was around him, with what people were going through every day, and try to find creative solutions to make life better.
Garden Matta Clark passed away at the age of 35 in 1978. Beyond his work, he tried to make art that made a difference, and that was highlighted in this exhibition. For BronxNet, I am Kadia-loy.